I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath. My wrath did end. I was angry with my foe. I told it not, and my wrath did grow. I watered it in fears, night and morning with my tears, and I sunned it with smiles, and with soft, deceitful wiles. It grew both day and night, but it bore an apple bright, and my foe beheld it shine, and he knew that it was mine. To my garden stole, and the night had veiled the pole. The morning cloud I see, my foe outstretched beneath the tree.
Performing arts.
Did you get that?
Yeah, I've got that. I've got that. Did you get yours?
No. I sent it back.
Oh, come on, guys. Give him a doctorate. Don't be wrong.
My essay technique was a bit avant-garde for a criminal investigator. You may talk of gin and beer when you're quartered safe out here. You're sent to penny fights and older shot it. But when it comes to slaughter, you'll do work on water and lick the blue boots of him that's got it. Now in India's sunny clime, where I used to spend my time, I serve in of Her Majesty the Queen. Of all them black-faced crew, the finest man I knew was our regimental Bisti, Gunga Din. With din, 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 you limping lump of brick dust, Gunga Din. Hey, slippy hither, oh, water get it, penny low. You squidgy nose though, the old idol, Gunga Din.
The shooter for me, all. There's nothing much before. And rather less than half of that behind. For a twisty piece of rag and a goatskin water bag, was all the field equipment he could find. When the sweating troop lane lay in a siren through the day, where the heat would make your blooming eyeballs crawl, we shouted, "Harry, bye!" till our throats were bricky dry. Then we whopped him till he couldn't serve us all. It was ding, ding, ding. You eating, where the mischief have you been? Oh, you heathen, where the mischief have you been? We put some jildy in it, or I'll marry you this minute, if you don't fill up my helmet, Gunga Din.
And he would dot and carry one until the longest day was done, and he didn't seem to know the use of fear. We charged or broke or cut, you could bet your blooming nut he'd be waiting 50 paces right flank rear, with his mussick on his back, and he'd skip with our attack, and watch us till the bugles made retire. And for all his dirty eyed, he was white, clear white inside, when he went to tender wounded under fire. It was din, 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 the bullets kicking in, dust spots on the green. When the cartridges ran out, you could hear the front file shout, "Aye, ammunition mules and Gunga Din." I shan't forget the night when I dropped behind the fight. I don't have to go on, is it?
That's fucking sad then, huh?
Yeah, it's amazing.
Stop is the bucket shop to pick the pieces of your life up. Scream looking glass, it's all that you despise. Picking back to the chicken shack and the smashing of the glass and the knife in the back. Well, my boy, who will believe your lies? All your lies. I sell you when the iron bars.
Dirty small town girls, how I wish you were here now. Show me how to be a man, as only you can, as only you can. My white city girl, well, someone said you were an angel. Only what kind of angel. Shove hello, or whisper goodbye, like my white city girl. I've seen you go down one too many times. It's just my bones to sing that line. All that line is taking all to mine. For the album keys, a pure in thought and word and deed. But oh my boy, what did you gain? Simply bought tools and stopped off cheats and holes in the ears of your baseball boots. And I meant you'll never forget your name for your lies. And no one's gonna sell you any alibis.
Everybody, this is Dylan, mm-hmm. and Dylan is from Hope Rehab, where Peter was for 3 months, and got some like real good clean time in and really good counselling. And Dylan and his colleagues up there got Peter into the best situation I've ever seen him in, really, for a very, very long time, and as some of you guys might have seen. And Dylan's going to try and make it down here more often to help with Peter's addiction. It's not an elephant in the room, Peter has addictions.
Ooh, yeah.
And we all need to acknowledge that, and we're just trying to figure out strategies to make it good for everybody, and for him not to feel alienated or the odd man out. And he's agreed to come and have a chat with you guys about it, answer any questions, give you some background to addiction. I know I can't speak for everybody in the room, but some people may have experience in it, some people may not. Dylan's got very specific experience in Peter's addiction because he treated it for 3 months very successfully.
Addiction is known as a chronic progressive disease. It manifests in the brain. So chronic means there isn't really any cure for addiction, so it progresses. So anybody who identifies themselves as an addict who sort of dabbles more with drugs is just feeding their addiction, really. So even though there is some level of harm minimization in ways, it's still fuel in the fire, it's still getting worse. But the nature of any chronic condition is that it's going to be prone to relapses. It's prone to relapses back. So most addicts do find that they take several serious attempts at trying to quit. Mm-hmm. The average actually is seven times that people go through a process of trying to change, seriously try to change, because obviously some people don't seriously try to change. And I don't think Peter has in the past. I don't think he really has tried to change. I think Hope probably was one of the first attempts of him seriously trying to change.
Pity, peace, and love of all prey in their distress, and to these virtues of delight return their thankfulness. For mercy, pity, peace, and love is God our Father dear, and mercy, pity, peace, and love is man's child and care. For mercy has a human heart, pity a human face. And love the human form divine, and peace the human dress. And every man of every clime that prays in his distress, prays to the human form divine, love, mercy, pity, peace. In all must love the human form, in heathen, Turk or Jew, and mercy, love and pity dwell. Their God is dwelling too.
Yes, mum. Yeah! That's what we've been trying to say for fucking years, man. That's what we've been trying to say for years.
I know, right?
Finally, we hit the nail on the head.
I know.
It's the same as a terminal illness, actually. The stress and worries, it's just like, say, the same as someone coping with someone like Alzheimer's, or it's just coping with someone who's got cancer or something like that. And one of the difficulties with addiction, obviously the manifestation of it being like a brain disease, you know, if his brain is now changed, it's maladaptive in certain ways toward, you know, and he has a psychological scotoma, which is narrowed tunnel vision to drug-seeking behaviour. And it's now a part of him. So even with good intentions, good intentions only make up a very, very small part of your brain. They make a very small part of your consciousness. All that undercurrent of his addiction, 15 years being at it, you know, really heavy use. In fact, some of the heaviest use I've ever seen in my whole career. In fact, most of the people I know that do the same amount as Peter are probably dead.
Kind of license anymore for that way of life anymore, that type of world anymore. What you done? Get out of my dreams, you scum. They weren't meant for anyone, they weren't meant for anyone but me. In my sinner magic mind, I see battles fought at sea. I awake in dawn's empire. It must be lonely being you, being me.
What you've done, get out of my dreams, you scum. They weren't meant for anyone but me. Impossible dreams, they
so I've got Furies to carry.
Furies were like harpies.
Yeah, exactly. Harpies, harpies. Yeah, like you said, it's two different.
You just do swing that.
Yeah, so yeah, they carry the souls of the dead hell.
Yeah.
So yeah,
that's Fury. Oh, really?
Yeah, so Furies are John Fury. That's heavy, heavy stuff.
Yeah.
So I've written a verse about every time I see a pain, man. I mean, you could use the verse every time you see me.
Oh, I'm on it.
No, don't look at it. Don't look at it. Don't be funny about it.
Nah, I'm on it. I'm locked in it.
But yeah, give me the idea to start writing, you know, that way.
That way
we can take a verse.
Set that up for me.
You type it while I'm playing my guitar.
Listen, with his dirty band.
Yeah,
you get it?
Yeah.
Dirty, pretty band.
Oh, leave it out. Then just make it nice, not about horrible shit.
Make it nice, he says. Just say with his dirty hands.
yeah, affectionately.
Alright, with his dirty, pretty band.
Yeah, I don't know if you like, but yeah, you write something nice anyway.
And his dirty, shitty fans.
No, write something nice as well. If you write like that, and then don't show me that one.
No,
alright. Yeah, I think it should be kind of like.
Every time I see my friend. He's always running away.
You can say pig man as well.
Every time I see my friend, he's just going around the band. He says to see me later. Yeah, alright. Every time I see the jig man, he seems to huff and he puff. Every time I see the jiggle man, he's fiddling with his phone. Oh, he hate that. Yeah. I never see an Instagram. Genius. But every time I see the pig man, he's trying to give a dog a bone. And then he put it on Instagram, and then he got it back at home.
What's it then?
No, no, that's going coming out of the middle eight,
just
going into the chorus.
Verse 3, verse 4.
Got it.
Should we first?
Yeah, I mean, that's a good question to ask, definitely. I mean, it's always been a really tricky one. And, you know, for years, people have looked at this, families of addicts, all kinds of people, friends and so forth. But the idea in any of the sort of treatment for yourself, really, is to focus on yourself, really. Focus on your own emotional well-being. If Pete's pissing you off or doing things that are annoying you, what is it about that? What is it saying about yourself, really? Because it's very difficult to control Peter. Mm-hmm. Peter's powerless against drugs, so you're powerless against controlling him in any way.
Yeah.
My specs are around me night and day. Like a wild beast guards my way. My emanation far within weeps incessantly for my sin. Fathomless and boundless deep. There we wander. There we weep. And the hungry, craving wind, my spectre follows thee behind. He sensed thy footsteps in the snow. Wheresoever thou dost go, through the wintry hail and rain, when wilt thou return again? Dost thou not in pride and scorn fill with tempests all my morn? And with jealousies and fears fill my pleasant nights with tears.
Yeah.
Do that?
Yeah.
It does. You die straight away.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Right. Right, let's go find it.
You know, you may say it's the wrong thing to do, but the thing that I've done is to try and keep them as safe as possible and as successful as possible, and with a long-term view of always, never losing sight of the fact that, you know, success musically is one thing, but it's also got to go hand in hand with the success in terms of his personal health. And you know, that's why I was very proud when it went to Hope, and he did as well as he did. If you take three steps forward and take two steps back, you've always taken one step forward. So we're not just talking about the remaining 4 weeks of making this album, it's the rest of his life.
It's the hour of the morning on the day after the dawning, when the sun they said would never set finally set again. Was it Cromwell or Orwell who first led you to the stairwell, which leads only forever to kingdom come? Rushed along by guiding hands, whispers of the promised land, they wished you luck and handed you a gun. It's so good to be okay.
something that could ever come to pass. All we tried one once before was the king's head on the floor, and we got booted out of Boozer cause someone smashed the glass. Life could be so handsome. Rocket run, it's not much fun. Biddy biddy. Walking back from the nightclub, I can't wait to get biddy biddy bummy rolling all the way. Bong the team. Rocket run, I always like rocket run. It's still a good tune.
The stuff the Libertines really can't be explained. It rages quite now here beside you and your lust for fame. But fame's such a sinister game. It will all end this way then. So things won't be the same. Just a face and a name on a page. But I'll be soundly sleeping.
I'll be soundly sleeping.
I'll sleep right through the days. Cause I can deal with all the blood on my shoes and holes in my soul. My spirit is tainted up. My tears are painted. Just so long as you don't forget to cut me on the wall by the defeated of all the things you just couldn't say. Shut me up the wall. Oh my darling, I was kind of loving. You let me in the family way again. Just on my tambourine really can't be explained.
Shake it more often.
I need to shake away the blame. But I'll be soundly sleeping. Taste the goulash in your mouth as you stumble off stage. I can deal with all the blood on my shoes and the holes in my soul. My spirit is tainted up. My tears are fainted. But just so long as you don't forget to cut me on the wall. From all the things you just can't say. Show me up the wall. Oh my darling, it was kinda lovely, but you dragged me in the family way again. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la.
till I turn to female love and root up the infernal grove. I shall never worthy be to step into eternity and to end thy cruel mocks, annihilate thee on the rocks, and another form create to be subservient to my fate. Let us agree to give up love and root up the infernal grove. Then shall we return and see the world of happy eternity. And throughout all eternity, I forgive you, and you forgive me.
Joy in the hearts of the boys and the